Assalamu alaikum dears, myself SLK, and today again we are facing a student's problem. A nice question was asked from a student about the given cantilever beam, and the question is, will the cross section of the given beam crack? Actually, the cracking is some kind of paling property. So the question is so nice and straightforward. It's a clear question. And some other properties are also given, like the breadth of the beam is 10 cm. And its depth is just 20 cm. The modulus of elasticity of the material and the maximum bending stresses of the material are also given. So I'll come straight into solution to answer the given question. Let's take a look for a moment to the question again. Will the cross section of the given beam crack? So it means I need the cracking moment over here. So I can compare the cracking moment with the moment caused by the external load. And to determine the cracking moment, of course, I can use the bending equation, which is just m over I, f over y, and u over r. Here, m represents the maximum bending moment, which is, of course, can be taken as the cracking moment. So, I'll just need the m over here to be calculated from this equation. For this approach, I'll take only two pairs from all these three pairs, like m over I, f over y. I need only m, which is just the bending moment, so I'll multiply I with both sides. So I can get, of course, m equals f over y times I. Now, if you remember, the m represents the cracking moment, which is just the maximum bending moment. We'll just assume the maximum bending moment as the cracking moment, no problem. Remember, the f is given, which is the maximum bending stresses. Y is given, which is the distance from the neutral axis up to the upper fiber of the beam. This time we'll take the y as the half of the depth. In the I is the moment of inertia, which is unknown. So I can calculate the I over here. Remember, this is just a rectangular section, and the moment of inertia about the neutral axis will be just BD cubed divided by 12. We need some plug-in check-ins for the breadth and the depth. Of course, we can plug all these guys as the breadth is just 10 centimeter times the depth is just 20, so 20 cubed divided by 12. We can get, of course, 66.67 centimeter pore. Actually, the pore is just the power, because the moment of inertia is just the second moment of the area. So I just need some plug-in check-ins to calculate the cracking moment. If you remember, F is given, which is just 75 kN per square centimeter divided by the Y. Remember, the Y will be taken as the half of the depth, which is, of course, 20 divided by 2 equals 10 centimeter, so divided by 10 times the moment of inertia is given over here. We can get, of course, 50,000 kN centimeter. This is, of course, just the cracking moment. So the cracking moment is just 5,000 kN centimeter. Now I need the moment by external load caused in the beam. Remember, this is just a cantilever beam with UDA, so of course I can use a nice equation like WL squared divided by 2. Remember, the L represents the length of the beam, which is just 3 meter, or I can say 300 centimeter. So 300 square divided by 2, of course I can get the moment caused by external load as 900 kN centimeter. You can clearly see the applied moment is maximum than the cracking moment. Of course, we can say the cross section of the given beam will crack. Oops, I'm sorry, the beam cross section will crack. Just comment your problem. We'll try to bring a nice solution as soon as possible. Thank you guys for watching. See you next time, and wassalam.